talk to me a little bit more than about your strategy. Like, who's going to be your captain?
Yeah, I think there's two factions of thought, right? Or there's two different types of thought. Like, one is taking one of these rookies, like a Victor Hovland, right? Who's probably going to be in four to, like Jeff mentioned, 4 to 5 matches. And you're going to save a lot and get a lot of these top guys. Or I'm going to probably lean more towards this is the experience on this side. Rory McIlroy is probably my favorite captain just because he and Rom are probably the two that I'm most confident in playing in all 5 matches. And I do think that if we see some of those practice round pairings guys, Rory was in that group with Hovland. So I could see a Rory Hovland, especially someone as experienced as Rory, stick with Hovland, the rookie. And even though both of those guys have a similar skill set, having both of their driving prowess on that same on the same pairing will be fantastic. So if it's not one of these rookies like Hovland, I'm going to try and go with one of his potential partners in Rory.
All right, Jeff, your captain is who?
Yeah, no, it's kind of the same deal. I really like Rory McIlroy. I think Hovland, you pair him with, but I think I'd rather captain Rory. You've got a better shot of getting the 5 matches. They could switch Hovland out if, you know, he just maybe ends up a little bit nervous off the start or something like that. I think that if you're creating a cash game lineup, I'd look to Xander Schauffele. Schauffele should be very, very chalky in the captain spot, though. So for GPPs, pay up for Rory, or maybe even pay down for a guy like Morikawa, who people seem to just be overlooking a bit, but he should play a ton, too.